I'm like, feeling your whole fit today.
I was like,
we don't see you in hoodies.
You don't see me in a hoodie. I said, if I'm going to wear a hoodie, I got to put a little pink on it. You know what I mean? I got to put a little spin on it. So shout out to EYL or your leisure.
You damn sure didn't come to play with this outfit.
I ain't planned to play. I'm going to keep my shades on for just a little bit. Y'all bear with me now. I'm feeling kind of fly.
Yo, y'all going to see a lot of pictures in this fit right now. Hit the marketplace. Let me tell you that right now. All right. So let's get back. Let's get to today's show. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Rants and Gems is the number one real estate show in the world.
Yes, it is.
Thank you guys for all your support, all your patience. I know the last couple episodes, y'all been in the comments. We hear you. Trust me, we're working through the kinks. Nothing is never perfect, but we're always going to push through and keep it going. All right? Somebody said them legs, though. Yo, stalkers, chill out in the comments, man. When I'm trying to do my job here, and y'all tripping in the comments already. Like, stop it, yo. She a married woman, man. Crying out loud. So, today's episode, we're going to discuss single-family house hacking.
Yeah.
Because, you know, online, we're always talking about multifamilies, mm-hmm. things of that nature. People say single-family homes are not assets. Their liabilities, which I agree with that to a certain extent, right? So let's talk about all the ways you can house hack a single family. Because, look, I'm not against people buying single family homes. I don't care if you buy a single family, a condo, a multifamily, a commercial multifamily. I just want our people to own some shit.
Correct.
And bridge this wealth gap, all right? So today we're going to give y'all all the tips, tricks, tips, hacks, all that good stuff about how to house hack your one family property. So let's set it off, Kiana.
Let me set this off. One thing I love about, you know, buying a single family home is when we're in Atlanta, we're in an equity state. So there's other places you can go where you can buy multifamily. Multifamily is readily available, but it's not readily available in our market. So we had to get creative. We have to get a little more creative about how we're going to turn that asset, mm-hmm. take that asset and make it income producing. How can we house hack, right? Because most of them are not going to be multifamily. They're not going to be a duplex. So we have other ways. So one thing about Atlanta, we are a Mecca. We're mm-hmm. the black Mecca, really. People love visiting Atlanta. Now we are one of those places that people like to tourist. We have tourists coming here. So Airbnb is really huge here in the metro Atlanta area. So what you want to do is if you get a property, make sure you get a single family home. And if you get a single family home and there's no HOA and there's no restrictions, then you're able to Airbnb the space without any issues. So Airbnb is a really huge way to get house hack your single family and produce an income. So I'm going to give you guys an example based on my personal experience. You know, a couple of episodes back, I bought the house in the city.
Absolutely.
Yeah, Matt has seen the crib in the city.
It is beautiful.
And I'm like, you know, I've been in this rock and a hard place. Do I want to live in the city? Do I want to stay in my country home? Of course, I'm married. It is what it is. I'm back in my country home. Compromises.
Facts.
But I still want to keep my city home, and I want to have access to it when I want to spend time in the city. So how do I do that? So we're putting it on Airbnb. It's about 4,000 square feet, 5-bedroom on a full and finished basement. And right now I'm able to yield $850 a night during the week and a $1,200 a night on the weekend.
Whoa, ho. You're going too fast. please repeat that.
So on this Airbnb property, and let me be clear, but it's decked out. Like I put about $25,000 in furniture in the property where we decked it out. I hired my designer. I want it to look beautiful. I'm going to tell you why in a minute. But Airbnb is only as good as what you pour into it. And I didn't go buy expensive furniture and expensive things. You know, I went to Home Goods. We went to TJ Maxx. We did a little bit of Wayfair. Like, I just dug, you know, we put it together really well. Mm-hmm. So I'm able to collect $850 a night, Monday through Thursday on wow. Airbnb. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, the rates are $1,200.
Wow.
And we already booked in November.
So y'all booked for the whole month of November.
We already got booked out. We literally just launched, and we're already booked. Like, we already have two bookings.
That's crazy.
So
House hacking.
It's house hacking. So I can block the dates that I know I'm going to be in the city. So let's say it's a concert coming out. Me and my husband are going to stay there. I'm going to block it for 2 days. But So I block out dates, but now I have an income producing asset that's going to pay for that house and give me a passive income.
Look, I love that, man. I think Airbnb is a great move, especially for those states where you don't have multifamilies.
Correct.
Do Airbnb. ADUs is also a big thing. Accessory dwelling units. Now, not everybody wants to have their property on Airbnb.
No.
It's a lot of work to maintain, cleaning, et cetera, et cetera.
I hired a management company. So I hired a property management company to handle that. I have no intentions of being the one to flip the sheets or manage the clients or manage anybody. Like, I hired a company to manage my Airbnb, and I just feel better about that decision because you got to pay to play a lot of times.
100%. You got to pay to play, and it's a smart move. That way you're busy. You ain't got time to be dealing with this.
No, you might
as well hire somebody to deal with this, right? So you got Airbnb. Now you got accessory dwelling units, right? And I'm having my phone in the hand, guys, just so I can read your comments. I hear you guys. It's being worked on. Don't worry, all right? ADUs, accessory dwelling units. These are homes that have an accessory apartment. In New York, we call them mother daughters. You know, in California, Florida, and a lot of different areas around the country, you guys should really look into buying a house that has a current ADU or the potential to have an ADU, all right? Now, you can use certain loan programs. You can use that rental income, if you're going conventional, from that ADU to help you qualify for a loan. If you have a garage and your county will allow you to turn that garage into an ADU, you can get a Fannie Mae home style renovation loan where you can transform that garage into an accessory dwelling unit. And now, in certain areas, depending on where your property is located, you just increase the value of your home as well, and you're collecting rental income. Now, you might not cash flow with an ADU, but it will supplement your income 110%. It will supplement you, so that way you have a lower mortgage payment. And this is also house hacking as well.
Absolutely.
You can rent out your basement, right? That's very popular in New York. Check your state and local, guidelines to see if it's legal or not. You know what I'm saying? Hey, make sure.
Because y'all be, let me tell you one thing about New York.
In New York, we don't care.
Y'all would rent out every room. Every room in the basement.
But that's another way to house hack.
Agreed.
Your house as well, right? You can rent out your room. I know folks who buy homes, right? Especially while they're young.
Yes.
They're single, no children, straight out of college, a couple years out of college, early in their profession.
Mm-hmm.
They're accustomed to having roommates because they went to college. They lived in dorms.
And so they're used to having roommates. Mm-hmm. And so they're not bothered by having people in their properties. And what that does is it puts you in a position where you can have them pay for the property and you can save your money. That's what house hacking is essentially. You're living for free. That's a house hack.
Facts. So there's ways to skin a cat when it comes to single family home ownership. You got ADUs, you can rent out rooms, you got Airbnb. Now, here's something that's really popular, and I'm like, Kiana, break this down a little bit more, is now renting out your home for content.
Oh, let me tell you. I'm more excited about the content house than anything else. So let me explain this to you, and this is how I came up with the idea. I work with a lot of people in film and in the industry, right? And they're always looking for different locations, different places that they can film. So now I'm doing my real estate. You know, you guys, if you follow me, you know I'm a little bit of the content queen. You know, I don't want to toot my own horn, but I'll say that when I'm ready to drop some content, it goes, right?
It's a whole production, y'all.
It's a whole production.
I'm telling you.
Sound, video, all that stuff. But these locations, they're not free, and they're not readily available.
Mm-hmm.
So when you want to go and shoot some content, where do you go? You don't want to do studio. Studio's kind of like, we're out of that. We want lifestyle. We want lifestyle video. We want lifestyle shoot. Where do you do that at? So I started to go to this website. When I shot my promo last year, this particular house charged me like $500 an hour with a 4-hour minimum.
Mm-hmm.
4-hour minimum.
Yep.
Just so I can film content.
That's two bands.
Now, it was a dope house. I needed it for the look I was trying to go for, so I paid it. And ever since then, I was like, you know what? I want to get a content house. So I used a website called Peerspace at the time.
Peerspace, y'all. Peerspace.
Peerspace.
Type that in the chat, please.
So I went to peerspace.com and I said, you know what? Look at all these properties that are listed And a lot of them aren't accommodating to business professionals, right? So as business professionals, especially in the real estate market, we want to shoot in a house, we want to be in a kitchen, we want to be in the office, we want to have all these options. So I decided to not only put my home on Airbnb, but my property that I own is called the Brookhaven House. It's easy to find on social media, the Brookhaven House. You can shoot content. I just did a full content shoot there, and I'm going to start posting a photo so you guys can see how easy it is for professionals, for anyone to go in there and shoot your content. That's why the decor was so important. Right now, based on my numbers, we're charging $350 an hour with a three-hour minimum just because we're just getting started. But ladies and gentlemen, that price will not remain that price for long.
Yeah, I mean, look, the price is up in stock. As we always say, right? The more demand it becomes, the more expensive it's going to be.
Absolutely.
Right? So take advantage. Even when we was out in L.A. and we were filming for the Assets Over Liability show, coming soon on Revolt, right? They booked the house.
Absolutely.
Right? So that way we can do content and everything in the house. And it was actually incredible. They, like you said, they booked it out for 4 or 5 hours.
Exactly.
And this was a house in the hills somewhere, so you know they ain't paying no $500 per hour.
Oh, I'm sure they paid extra.
That was probably like $1,000 an hour, but you got to, and it looked like somebody was living in the house still.
Absolutely.
Right? And you paid for a certain area of the house to use.
And that's what I like best about PeerSpace and using those type of sites, because you can literally still be in your home. If you're a homeowner, I've done content shoots where the homeowners are like, well, you only have access to the exterior, the living room, the kitchen. Like, it's assigned areas, and they're still there protecting their homes. Like, they're still there to make sure you're in and out, and you're actually, like, not trashing the house.
Mm-hmm.
That's the difference between Airbnb and, like, a PeerSpace, where it's like, these are the only locations you can be in. You can only be here for 4 hours. I'm going to get my money. I don't have to worry about changing sheets and all that stuff, because you're really just taking photos and you're doing video. And when you leave, I'm sanitizing behind you, and I've made my mortgage.
That's a fact. Look, and everybody just want to get their mortgage paid.
Absolutely.
By any means necessary. And when you're house hacking a single family, these are ways you can get your mortgage paid, right? So look, I want to...
Ask some questions?
We had somebody who asked a couple good questions, and I'm trying to roll up. Here, they was talking about, how do you find an Airbnb manager, property manager?
Well, luckily, my friend, she's already managing her Airbnb, so it was easy for me to get with Kendra. Shout out to Kendra Sanders.
Shout out to Kendra.
So she actually already does this, and she made 6 figures in 6 months. So she was just like, I'm like, listen, if you can do that with yours, you can do that with mine. I'm gonna give you mine. So it's Atlanta Lux B&Bs. If you want to follow her, Atlanta Lux, L-U-X B&B. But I came across her because she's a girlfriend of mine. I'm not saying work with her. I'm saying that she does an excellent job. But you want to find someone to manage it, and they will charge a fee. But I'm not changing sheets. I'm not checking behind people. I've been around her. Me and her have been hanging out where people have had parties at one of her Airbnbs, and her assistant, the people she manages for the company, had to go out and clear people out. Like, I'm not on that type of time.
You ain't for that.
I can take the shades off.
You ain't about that life?
No, I'm not about that life. So I prefer to have someone just manage it for me and make sure I don't have to do none of those things, you know? And it's certain things that they do. It's certain locks they use, certain entry and exit strategies that they have. So, you know, I personally prefer to have someone else manage it for me. But I feel like if you do enough research, maybe you can manage it yourself.
Nah, look, if you got that type of time, then why not? Manage it yourself, save yourself 10%, 15%, whatever it is, but make sure you do right by your investment.
Correct.
Because you want to make sure you become a super host and you do what you got to do.
Correct.
And
she's
bookings,
a super host.
To keep your bookings keep going. Now, Malik Burton said, is an ADU an additional attached unit on a single family? It could be an attached unit. It could be an attached garage. But I would probably say it's more of a detached. It's really how you really want it to be. So that way it's separate from your house. It's like a guest house.
Right.
Right? Or think about Fresh Prince of Bel Air, when Carlton and Will had to stay in the pool house, right?
Right.
So if you're getting Bel Air type money, maybe you got a pool house.
Maybe.
Who knows, right?
That's different.
And you turn that joint into an ADU and you get some money from it, right?
I see a lot of ADUs in Atlanta, especially with they're doing new builds. I met with a builder. And this was like a project that I'm still kind of working on. Matt knows about it. And he builds ADUs above the garage with an entryway behind the kitchen. So it's like separate but detached. So you can't really record it as a duplex or multifamily, but you can create an income producing property off of that by having an ADU. So ADUs are really, they're becoming very popular in Atlanta.
Look, they're
especially for zoning.
For zoning, it's going to help increase your value, but again, it's supplementing your mortgage payment.
Absolutely.
It's creating the opportunity and a space for areas and towns that don't have multifamily homes.
Correct.
To be able now for folks to be able to house hack, to be able to supplement and bring an income, and now you're turning your single family into an asset. So when people say single family is not assets, I look at them like they're crazy sometimes. I'm like, yo, it could be an asset if you're willing to sacrifice and do what you have to do to earn some money. Right now, everybody, quick commercial break. I need you, first and foremost, to like this video, all right? Second thing, I need to give a big, big shout out to our sponsor. And this is a commercial break real quick. I got to do it mid-show because I forgot to do it in the beginning, all right? So shout out to Andre Barad of Yes to Real Estate in Houston, Texas. He sponsored tonight's live. If you're interested in sponsoring any future shows, email info@rantsandgems.com. But Andre is a realtor, investor, developer of residential real estate. He's on track to close $20 million in real estate in Houston, which, look, you know, as a realtor, that is a number.
Let me tell you, y'all see me clapping my hands like
that is a number, my God.
Let me tell you something. That's the number. It's a hard number.
Especially, it's not like you're in New York. You're in, like, Texas.
Houston is like Atlanta.
Exactly.
Their price points are they're very much so like ours. Average price point, about $400,000. Mm-hmm. So you got to work a little harder to get to that $20 million. So shout out to you.
So shout out to Andre and that. So Andre and the Yes to Real Estate team, they work hard every day with regular, hardworking folks just like you guys. They turn these folks into successful investors. They work with people who are looking to do new construction, townhomes, fix and flips. They do it all, you name it. Go check out Andre Barad and the Yes to Real Estate team in Houston, Texas. Go to yes2realestateteam.com for more information, all right? That was a quick commercial break.
Let's
get back to the show.
Back to the show.
That was the first time we ever did that.
And that was. I'm feeling like we're really official. Come on, Rant.
Come on, man. If you want to sponsor some Rants and Gems shows, we have sponsorship opportunities. Email info@rantsandgems.com. Okay, back to the show.
Back. So, yeah, I think that what we have to do is, and I know so many people that want to get into house hacking, and your mind is set on getting multifamily. Depending on your state, it may not yield you those same results. Like Atlanta, we are not a multifamily state. Atlanta, the city of Atlanta, surrounding counties, it's gonna be hard for you to find a property that's affordable that is a multifamily. So we have to look at alternative options that you can still use to house hack so you can also still be successful. So why not use opportunities like PeerSpace, use Airbnb, also Gigster, Gigster, G-I-G-G-S-T-E-R.
Put Gigster in the chat, please. Gigster in the chat.
Gigster is also another site you can use to put your property on there. It's like PeerSpace, it's just a different platform. So you can get paid per hour for some people to go in and do content in your space. So a lot of you guys have beautiful homes, beautiful kitchens. Like, you can tell them they can only shoot in your kitchen. And if you're in the metro Atlanta area, keep in mind, we're doing a lot of film now. And they need places to film and to shoot. So why not allow yourself to make that passive income? Mm-hmm. I mean, all you have to do is just sit in the kitchen. I had one lady, she sat in the kitchen on her laptop the whole time while I was shooting all over her house. And when I left, she said, have a good day. And I'm sure she made her mortgage plus.
Oh, 100%.
Yes.
You already know she did.
I know she did. That's why I was excited to get my content house. I've been talking about this for a year.
Look, and the more you talk about it, the more I'm like, I have a house that I'm living in right now. I'm about to move out of that joint. And I'm like, damn, should I Airbnb this or should I make it content?
Listen,
I might do a combo of both.
You could do both. You know,
They don't have that in New York.
Yes, and you know so many realtors in New York. And one thing about, you know, I have to keep it honest, Atlanta runs things.
Oh, my God. Here we go, y'all.
Atlanta, we run things when it comes to content. I don't care what you say. It is what it is. When it comes to content and how the real estate agents, how we do things here, what we do, everybody else follow. It is what it is. Say something.
Okay. I'm going to agree with that.
Thank you.
All right. I'm going to agree with that.
So
I'm going to agree with
that. I bet you if you had a content house in New York, those agents will go up there, they'll make plenty of content, they'll be in the kitchen, they'll be sharing their market updates, they'll be able to get it out there. Like,
nah, that's a fact.
Content is the new currency right now.
Content is king.
Content is king, content is currency. If you're not creating content, if you're a business owner, you played yourself.
Nah, content is king, and you can definitely run it up with content houses.
Absolutely.
It's a brilliant idea. I will give ATL Realtors your props when it comes to everything that y'all do from a content perspective. I would give y'all props. Y'all joint be looking clean.
Matt be wanting to give us our props, but Matt was like, y'all closing days here is like a full production. Like,
yeah.
he called us show business.
Yeah, Atlanta real estate is like show business. You don't see nothing in the world like full productions at closing tables like in Atlanta. I mean, they be having photographers, videographers, makeup, hair, closing gifts, Versace robes. I'm like, yo, what are y'all doing? They be renting out sprinters, champagne. I'm like, yo, what's happening here? They don't do this nowhere else.
They don't.
So I'll give y'all your props. Thank that shit you. Look good as hell, too.
Appreciate it.
I'm going to start doing it, too, FYI.
I'm telling you.
Why not?
It's an experience. People love to be a part of an experience, you know? And so when I say that, to say content houses are the new are going to be a big thing. Content is ruling the world right now. Social media is not slowing down. So if you have a property and you have a single family home, and you feel comfortable. First, you feel comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, it looks good. It got to look good. Consider putting your properties on at least PeerSpace and Gigster to see the reactions to it, because it's not like Airbnb. They're not staying the night. They're only there for a couple of hours. Let them shoot their content. You go into a space that they're not going to be able to shoot in, and you create a passive income source for yourself. At least cover the house expenses, at the very least.
Look, it's all about being smart. Working smarter, not harder.
Absolutely.
And especially if you're living in a high cost state where, you know, the average house may run you $700,000-$800,000.
Absolutely.
To be in a good area, use the resources wisely. Now, obviously, people who have families and stuff like that, this might not be the conversation for you.
Correct.
Because this might not be something you're willing to sacrifice. And you may not need to house hack this because you have enough capital to just go buy investment properties, right? But this episode, we want to dedicate it to the folks who want to buy single family properties, who want to buy condos, right? Because she's a single family selling queen.
Right.
Right. And that's all they really have out here in Georgia, or Atlanta, I should say. So we wanted to have a special episode and do it live so that way we can get y'all feedback while we're talking. Because this is an important conversation.
It's important, and this is more than one way to skin a cat. I think that we're so caught up. Like, every investment doesn't have to be, oh my God, this is a dirty, raggedy house, and I'm knocking down the walls, and I'm putting in new tile, and I'm putting in new plumbing. I literally bought this house. This house was brand new. I purchased the property. When I closed with $75,000 in equity. Not only do I already have instant equity, I'm able to create that type of income. $800 a night, cover my mortgage, $1,200 a night, $350 an hour. Like, think about things like that. Just because you purchase a single family home and it's a beautiful property doesn't mean that it's not a smart purchase, as long as you use it right. You know, we have to get out of that mindset that it's only one way to create generational wealth. It's only one way to do things. What if you just bought a beautiful $1 million property and now you're like, I'm gonna turn it into a content house, and you're going to be able to create and make that income while you still live there? That's a two for one for me. There's nothing mm-hmm. wrong with that. We have to be able to show people that there's more than one way, because I know people that will just personally, they may not want to live in an area that's gentrifying or an area that's transitioning. They may not want to live in a home or move into a property that takes a lot of work. Some mm-hmm. people can't just, you know what, let's be honest. Some people simply can't afford it. Let me talk about it.
Facts.
Let's say you buy a $500,000 house. It's turnkey. You have your down payment and your closing costs, but it's turnkey. All you have to do is furnish it, and now you can use one of these sites, and these sites can help you pay your mortgage. As opposed to, let's say you buy a $350,000 house, you got to put $50,000 in work into it. What if you don't have that capital?
Yeah, yeah.
And what if you don't have enough equity in the asset to pull out? So then you're kind of stuck because you're following rules that don't apply to you.
Agreed.
I think we all have to stick to what applies to us and see, are you in the mood to flip? Some people just don't want to deal with flipping.
Agreed.
Some people don't want to deal with having to get a project manager. Like, even when I renovated my personal home, remember when I did that last year?
Yeah, came out beautiful.
Thank you. But let me tell you, the budget.
Blown.
I remember asking my project manager, what if I just didn't have the money? Because that's how much we were, like, what was y'all going to do? To stop? Because that's how much above budget we were. Yeah. The contingency plans, even if with the contingency, it's just so high. So I'm not discouraging you to renovate. I'm just giving you another option to take the asset you already own, if you already own the property, throw some nice little Wayfair furniture in it, go to Home Goods, throw some pictures up.
Go to IKEA.
Go to IKEA and turn it, get you some, put it on the content website and create a passive income source for yourself.
So we got a question from Lil Harv. Lil Harv says, what do you think about tiny houses and Airbnb in them in the tiny communities?
I think it's amazing. I know someone that actually has a small cabin and they're sold out all the time because it's sold as an intimate space.
And it's an experience.
It's an experience. People want to be in tiny homes. Like there's, because it's that sense of peace. We all need to slow down. Mm-hmm. So if I had a tiny house, what I would do is I would take a tiny house and turn it into one of those spaces where it's like a quiet space, very relaxing, very much so like that zen situation.
Yeah, yeah. Lots of candles.
Lots of candles. Include a recommendation for a massage therapist.
Yeah.
Turn it into one of those things. See, when you take small items like this, you take niche things, niche it down, add experiences to
it. Absolutely.
You can charge more.
Absolutely.
People are paying for peace right now. They'll pay for it, and you'll be able to make your income. I think it's a great idea.
I think it's a great idea, too. I second everything she said. I'm not going to go any further into that. Imani Bailey says she was recently kicked completely off Airbnb site and community with little to no explanation. My emails have gone unanswered, and Airbnb claims that that's the final decision. Any advice at all? Hell, go to these other sites.
VRBO. What about VRBO? People forget about VRBO.
Go to VRBO.
Do VRBO. Do that. And what you want to... Who said you can't start a new profile? All I'm saying is...
I'm just saying.
All I'm saying, you know how many times you can make a new email address? 100. Okay? The addresses are not listed on Airbnb.
Word.
Photos are only listed. That's what I would do. New email address, new listing. What's up?
And that's a fact. I agree with that. Look, there's more than one way to skin a cat.
Right. We got to get creative.
Create a different profile, I guess.
It'd be a whole other name. Saying?
And figure it out from there. Yeah. But in this episode, we gave you so many different options, you know, at least three or four different options.
Correct.
Where you can go to different websites and you can still make money. You just got to be creative. There's always a marketplace for something.
Okay.
Now, you can create your own your Instagram page and make it your own Airbnb and just market and run ads.
Listen.
Right?
There's so much you can do. Like
And you cut out the middleman.
You cut out the middleman. And especially when it comes to content. Now, be careful with that, because I know this happened before in this couple in California.
Mm-hmm.
They called themselves cutting out the middleman when it comes to Airbnb. And when they did that, the actual woman decided that she was now a tenant.
Whoa.
And they couldn't kick her out for 30 days.
See, whoa.
And she started with Airbnb. Then they was like, we can cut her out and you can stay. So I think a lot of times, I'm not going to cut off my nose to spite my face. I'm not walking over $100 to pick up a nickel. So what you want to do is think about that too.
You definitely got to think about that. You got to weigh out all your pros and cons at anything in real estate, because you never know. People try to be squatters. They try to play the
game. Yes, and that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, people play the game. So just be careful on whatever way you go. Cheryl Prince says, tiny spaces near the water are the best. There you have it. Experience. People want to be near the water. True Nicole wants to know if we're still hiring for a real estate assistant.
Is that for me?
I guess. Email your resume.
Email your resume, please.
Yeah, email your resume, please. But yeah, this has been a good episode so far. Lots of information.
I think what we want to do is you want to get out of the mindset, especially I know it's a lot of real estate agents and professionals that are on this, that come on to here and they're like, you know, you can't just be the one selling the property. At some point, you got to also invest. And then there's a lot of people that want to invest, your first time investors, and you getting fed all this information, but you already own a house. Why not turn the home that you already own into an investment property and create a passive income instead of thinking like, oh, I got to hurry up and go get this house and I got to flip it and I got to fix it and I got to get a hard money loan. Like, make it easy on yourself. Just take a step one to creating a passive income source and then take a step two and three and four. I'm just trying to make it easy for y'all, because I get the calls of people that are drowning in flips.
Absolutely.
They be drowning.
A lot of people are drowning.
Them flips be turning to flops because you got all this information, but you didn't quite understand that $20,000 budget you had and then that $10,000 contingency plan is being spread out now. Now it's 30,000. Now the prices have increased. Now the spread is lower. Like, you didn't mm-hmm. account for any of that. And I just want to at least see you start making some passive income, seeing how things go, and then kind of walk yourself into flipping and walk yourself into getting that second income producing property. Like, even with like one of my agents, she had a renter trash her whole house. Huh. Trashed it. I'm talking about police kicked in the door, trashed, carpet destroyed, you know.
Welcome to the dark side.
Welcome to the dark side of being a landlord. No one talks about that, because I always talk about be a landlord, collect extra money per month. What about when they trash your property? So you got to just kind of start setting yourself up to say, you know what, there's more than one way to invest. There's more mm-hmm. than one way to create a passive income source, and just take each step.
So Mike Racine says, should I start with lease properties on Airbnb or should I purchase first? I think you got to do whatever you're comfortable with. I know right. a lot of people do, you know, Airbnb arbitrage and they rent out. But they're cracking down on that stuff a lot.
Oh, let me tell you, it's out of control.
It's getting out of control because everybody's teaching about this and everybody's going out here and doing these things. And it's getting cracked down a lot. So I'm a fan of ownership. I would rather you own the property so no one can tell you what you can or cannot do with your own property.
I agree. I mean, with me, I own it. No one can tell me what to do. I can have as many people in there as I want to. The neighborhood has no HOA. Like, that was important mm-hmm. to me. And I think when you're doing this arbitrage, and I'm in this really big Facebook group, but I'm only in there for market research. It's an Airbnb group, but I'm only in there just to be quiet for market research. And I can tell you, they're getting fined. They're cracking down. If you can figure out how to make it work and you feel comfortable, do it. But there's more control in ownership. That's just really the truth.
No, it's definitely more control of ownership. And look, we're here to bridge the wealth gap. So you guys doing arbitrage, I'm not knocking your hustle.
Correct.
Right? But let's just say they changed the entire rules of Airbnb, right? And you can no longer do the arbitrage and you can't lease and do this. Now you're stuck. Your business model is screwed because now you don't own anything. So I think it's just very important to control your own destiny. And ownership is very important. Now, if you can't go out there and buy while the rules are still in your favor, hell, hack the system. Do what you got to do. Just make sure you do your due diligence, your knowledge, and you know exactly what you're getting yourself into, because you don't want to get sued or anything like that. Now, someone asked about condos to start with Airbnb. I don't like condos for Airbnb because of HOAs. Right.
That's what I was going to say.
That cuts into your profit.
It cuts into your profit, and a lot of times they don't allow it. One of the properties I owned, I ended up selling it because they wouldn't even allow me to rent it anymore. They started fining me per day, like $250 per day. So I was like, let me sell this asset. It's no longer something I can use. When you have a condo, if they don't allow for you to do Airbnb in short term, it's easier for you to get caught, too.
Mm-hmm.
It's easier because people are going in and out. Elevators, cameras, front door people. It's easier for you to get caught when you're doing that. Some people do like condos, especially in the city,
yeah.
view lines and all that stuff. But if it's a place that doesn't allow it, and a lot of places don't allow it.
Absolutely, they're
but
cracking
the
down.
The issue is not even about, it's not the condo owners, it is the cities.
It's the cities, yeah.
The cities are cracking down because the hotels are suffering. The hotels pay a certain service tax to the city. So Airbnb started to cut that down, so they're cutting them out. So it's more political than most people think.
It's a lot of politics when yeah. all of these industries are being disrupted.
Absolutely.
Right? These industries have been, you know, running it up for decades.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And with the internet, disruption is happening all over. So these people are in power. They pay the lobbyists. They pay the politicians off. Mm-hmm. And they want their money back.
Agreed.
Y'all coming on their block, taking food off their table, and they're not happy about it. And at some point, I think all of this stuff, Toro, Airbnb, arbitrage, I think all this stuff at some point will come to a halt, or they will make it so tough for people to be in the game, you know what I'm saying? Just with licensing requirements and all this other stuff.
Yeah.
You know, they're going to do whatever they can to, you know, squeeze, especially us, now that we're learning this stuff.
Because one thing about us.
We go hard.
Okay, let me say something.
We go
hard in the paint. But when we learn something, we take it. We don't take it there. We take it there. We take
facts.
We ain't going to take it a little far. We're going to take it way too far. So there are people that you may not own a property, but you got 35 Airbnbs from a corporate rentals, and because you learn from this person, you learn from that person, and you're making a great income. And I'm not knocking it. But when we do things like that and you don't own, don't be surprised when you have no control.
Facts.
You see these signs. If you're in an Airbnb, report them now. We'll pay you $1,000. Those are things that are being posted in this private Airbnb group I'm in. where they're showing, like, the property managers are putting signs everywhere. If you're in an Airbnb, I'll report you for $1,000. I would, even if I stayed there. I get my
luck.
I'm staying in, I'm getting my money. Luck. Let's be real. I'm going to stay in, I'm going to get paid. I'm doing both because they're going to report it. So, and people are doing that. And a lot of people are upset, but you have no control when you don't own. So still do Airbnb, do whatever is comfortable. When you're getting all this money from these corporate rentals, I would hope that you would take some of that money and invest in a portfolio of properties that you own that you can legally and with clear mind actually put on Airbnb.
Absolutely.
And now you have control. That's my hope.
The name of the game is ownership, people. We got to stop trying to take the shortcuts.
Yeah. Right? They work for a little while, though. They do work.
They do.
I ain't no hate.
Get your money. Look, yeah. Get your money. I ain't one hit to count your pockets, right? Get your money. But also, what's your exit? Everything you do in life, there has to be an exit to it because on any given Sunday, it can come crashing down.
True.
And then what are you going to do next? Right. So whatever arbitrage and hacks that anybody who's watching this live or on a replay, and if you're watching this live, please hit that like button, please, and share this with 10 people. OK,
so like and share.
Like and share with 10 people. Right. So if you are going to do these hacks, make sure if you got bad credit, fix your credit.
True.
And the best credit repair company is called Pay Your Damn Bills. OK.
Listen,
pay your damn bills. OK.
I saw that meme. I said, man.
That's the best for y'all who are gonna ask me, what's the best credit repair company?
Pay your bills.
that's the best credit repair, right? So pay your bills, get your credit scores up, save your money for your down payment. Don't go buy Balenciagas and Off-Whites and all this other good stuff.
If you really can't
afford it right now, stay down till you come up. Bad boys move in silence. You don't need to be keeping up with the Joneses.
And at the end of the day, we all need an extra strategy because I'm telling you, like, you get tired of moving around. I posted something the other day that was like, I'd rather make $150,000 passively than make $250,000 with actual hard work, right? So with me being in the field,
I think some people miss what you just said.
Let me say it one more time.
Repeat that. I may clip this.
Let me explain. I'd rather make $100,000 passively than to make $250,000 by being out in the field doing major hard work. And as a real estate agent, let me tell you, hard work is getting in the car, showing every house, negotiating every contract, on the phone all the time, fighting over $10, fighting over a garbage disposal, trying to keep the deals together, praying that they close. Like, I do that every day. Thank God that I was able to use that money to actually invest in different assets. I'm so excited about this content house. I really don't know what to do with myself. Like, I don't know. I'm like this. I don't know what to do with myself because I bought the house and I can just sit back, it's decorated, and I can just get paid every single month and I don't have to do anything. That is what you want. You want to create, you got to create passive revenue streams.
Look, passive income is the name of the game.
Yes.
You need multiple streams of income. One stream of income is too close to being broke.
Agreed.
You know what I'm saying?
Agreed.
So like, you got to be creative. To all my condo and single family home buyers, we gave y'all a lot of information in this
If you don't at least just try to post a picture of your kitchen and put it on Pure Space and Gigster, I know something. Really, like
that's a fact.
Because you can literally pay your mortgage in 30 days.
All of you guys who are currently homeowners, or if you're gonna be homeowners, if you're gonna put your properties on any of the sites that we mentioned, put in your stories, tag us to it.
Yeah.
We want to see your success. We want to see you guys out here executing this information because we're not here for our freaking health. Let me tell you, it's a lot of work trying to put together shows.
This is my third look of the day.
That is a fact.
More.
We got one more look after this, all right? We've been filming all day, drinking wine, having great conversations to bring you guys some of the best real estate people in the world.
Listen, I'm putting my personal business out here telling y'all how
that is a fact.
I like to show you, I want to lead by example because a lot of people can blow smoke. My content house can actually be booked. This is no cap. It's real, and I'm really excited about doing this, but at the same time, like, I want other people to know, like, I see so many of us trying it. You don't have to buy, you can just buy a nice looking house with no HOA and get paid and get corporate rentals and all that stuff instead of thinking from one standpoint. We have to be able to expand our brain to understand that I don't have to get a house and knock it all the way down and build it all the way up to be an investor. I can actually buy a home that's already ready, put it on these sites, make it pretty, sit back and collect my checks.
That is a fact. Pay attention to the information that we're giving y'all. This can change your life. Execute. And if you guys are out there executing and ransom gems,
we want to see it.
We want to see it.
Please tag us.
Tag us to it. Do something so we can see the success. Because look, like I said, this takes a lot of work for us. And this is free, right?
Correct.
But free game costs money. You better believe. You think this sign right here was free?
I wish I could see. Like, I wish they could see.
This is free game costs money. All right. And I'll probably put the setup in my stories today so you guys can see. But if we're going to invest to bring content to you guys and information to you guys, you guys got to do the next best thing. And that's go out there and execute and show us that you're executing, because we're both executing in real life what we're doing. So we need you guys to do the same as well.
And I can't wait to show you guys even that when it comes to me doing my portfolio, when it comes to stocks. Shout out to Trapper for really the education.
Big Trout.
Even when it comes to Sabine, give me the information on
shout out to Sabine.
My assets. Like, I'm not just on here sharing things, but I'm also a student. Like, I want to know, too. And some things I was unaware of or not executing, and now we're all in it together.
We all in it together. We all got the same goal, and that's to build Black home ownership one brick at a time. We got to close this racial wealth gap. We started behind, but that's okay. Now we're here, and there's nothing that they can do. And hopefully, information that we bring to you, hopefully information that Earn Your Leisure, you know, all of our friends, Ian, the Master Investor, Big Trap, you know, everybody, the whole crew, that everybody's bringing y'all this information. Hopefully you guys are investing and going out there and executing at a very high level. Another thing I want to tell you guys, please, there's about 600 plus of y'all watching this live with you. I appreciate y'all rocking with us. Make sure not only you watch it here on Earn Your Leisure's YouTube channel. In order for Rants and Gems to be the number one real estate podcast in the world on the charts, go to Apple, rate it 5 stars.
Or Spotify.
Leave a review, subscribe, most importantly, and listen to it on audio. You know, the downloads, listening to it, the reviews, those mess with the algorithms, and it pushes us out to more people in our community. This information is very important. So if you guys are not doing your part in helping us get this information, it's all for waste, right? So we gotta, that's how you support Rants and Gems. This, like I said, this is a free game.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm
free
saying?
Free game. And I forgot about one more thing.
Keep going.
I gotta tell you, and I gotta get the name of it, but you need to also market your property to traveling nurses.
Facts.
Let me tell you something.
Traveling nurses.
They got money. They got the money, and they come 3 and 4 at a time. They want to stay in the house. They're in and out. They have 1 month and 2 month assignments.
Yes.
And they come in and out. So what you want to do is Google traveling nurses wherever city you're in, and look up housing for traveling nurses for whatever city. Find out what sites they're using. If you know a traveling nurse, plug them in. I know three. I'm plugging them into the Content House, to the Brookhaven House as we speak, because they are always, like, not only are they're going to take care of your property.
Yep.
All they're going to do is use the coffee maker.
Yep.
And they're in and out. And they barely
a day or two.
Earn the property. They in and out, and it's going to be great for you. So look at those types of things. People that are in and out of cities. People that are.
Pilots. Flight attendants.
See?
They're all over the place.
All those things. Like,
right?
Those are people that you want to target. Like, you guys can make a passive income if you were to position yourselves right. Think about things another way.
There's many ways you can skin a cat, like you
absolutely.
Said. Especially with the pilots and
traveling nurses.
The traveling nurses and the flight attendants.
Flight attendants, absolutely.
Right? Those folks are on the move. You know, traveling nurses will be a little bit more steady.
Because they're going to stay, but
they're going to stay for
thing.
A couple months,
they're
right?
They're going to stay for about a month.
But the pilots and the flight attendants, 1 to 3 days.
Correct.
Tops. And they're going to pay top dollar because they're not paying for the most part. Nope. You know what I'm saying? They're getting reimbursed. So if you're positioned close to airports and things of that nature and you got a good product, that's what you need to be marketing to, all right? I mean, with social media, again, you can target ads.
You can target ads and
promote your property.
You know, we just have to get out of that. Like, I really want people to know. And I get this all the time, like, you know, oh, you know, that's not an investment, or single family is not a good investment. Single family is a good investment if you do it right. Like, even my personal property, it's a hell of an investment.
Facts.
I'm sorry, I don't ran the numbers. I showed Matt the numbers.
Facts.
Matt, like, seriously.
My single property is my primary is a great asset. I don't care what nobody says.
And we ain't even got to go there with it.
And let me tell you why it's a great asset. Because I do a lot of my business. I have my home office, right?
Me too.
You have a home office. Uncle Sam likes home offices. We like things like that, right? And I make money from working in my office, which
Absolutely.
Is at home. So, look, there's many ways to skin it. You just got to know how to get it and use the tax code to your advantage and make things happen. So, look, we're coming up 650. We got other things coming on the channel tonight. Like I said, big shout out to Earn Your Leisure. Congratulations again on the show on Revolt.
I got to actually give a shout out to them.
Please,
you know,
do.
For real. Like, Rashad and Troy, I'm so proud of you guys.
Facts.
I'm super proud of you. And, you know, this is what you've been working hard for. You know I support you. I got on the sweatshirt. You got me
she
on.
Got on
you,
she got yo, Bam, she got it on,
got
son.
It on.
I'm going to make her do a commercial for you, Bam.
I really want someone to say something. I'm officially wearing the Assets Over Liabilities sweatshirt. I think that you guys should definitely get this. Women, it fits well. I had to put a little jazziness to it, but this one is for breast cancer awareness. And their new show, Assets Over Liabilities, will be on Revolt. And when I went to their premiere, I was just so proud of the guys because they've been holding down this financial literacy thing for a long time.
Yeah.
And someone even posted a video of like the first interview I did with them when they mm-hmm. were doing the tour here in Atlanta.
Yeah.
And I just remember where we were then, like all of us. And
yeah.
then seeing where they are now, like, I'm so proud to be on this network with you guys.
Yeah, this has been an incredible journey. And just to see how the doors have been opening up over the past 2.5 years
mm-hmm.
and, you know, becoming the biggest ever.
Yes.
And within that time frame, it hasn't been easy. It's a lot of work. It's a lot of ups and downs. But, you know, I'm super proud of the guys. Yeah. They also was nominated for the best business podcast
yes.
by iHeart. So I don't know if it's a voting system or not, but obviously if it's a voting system, we're going
to
have y'all flood that
because
we got to take that because it's the number one podcast, business podcast in the world, in my opinion, and many of you guys' opinions, but we want the trophy.
We need the trophy. What I feel like, you remember like when Bad Boy was like number one, like little,
Absolutely.
Like I feel like I'm signed to Bad Boy.
Nah, this is the new Death Row. We outside. We outside. We taking over the financial literacy game. And you know, look, again, congratulations to them. Can't wait for you guys to see the Assets Over Liability show
that's
coming out because, you know, I've been at the shows, at the tapings, the behind the scenes stuff. And it's an incredible show, guys. So I think you guys are really going to love that. And, that's all we got for you guys. Like I said, you guys got to go out here. Let's make Rants and Gems now the number one real estate pod in the world, the number one show in the world. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Tell your friends. Tell a friend. Tell a friend.
Tell a friend to tell a friend. And tell a friend and listen to this. Listen to the information. Execute the information, tag us, put us in your stories. Like, we want to see you executing. If we're going to go into season 2, which is 2022,
yes.
season 2 in 2022, we want more interaction. We want you guys, we want to feel like we're giving you the value that you deserve. And don't worry, we're about to get our website is going to drop.
Yes.
So you can give us some feedback on what you want to hear from us.
Facts.
So we can start giving you value, continue to give you value so you can grow your real estate portfolios, so you can protect your assets, so you can own some shit. Shout out to Aisha.
So you can
own your life, own your name, own everything.
Yeah, and look, live audiences. I know you a lot of y'all been asking, yo, Matt, when you bring about the live audiences, that's going to come back in 2022.
Yes.
No more live audiences for the rest of this year, but 2022, hell, we might do a little mini tour. Who knows?
Yeah.
So stay tuned for that. And that's pretty much all I got for you guys. Make sure, again, you rewind this. If you came in late, watch the beginning of this video. We love you guys. Thank you for the support.
Appreciate it.
And make sure you guys like this video on YouTube as well. Again, it's 6:55 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so we're about to sign off. You got any final words you want to say before we get out of here?
My final words are, make sure you take this information and execute. Follow the Brookhaven House. Also, keep up with ATL Lux B&B if you're looking for a manager of your assets. Like, you're going to see me on this journey of creating a passive revenue income source with this first investment to be a content house. 2022, I plan to get a second one. So make sure that you guys are liking, subscribe, comment, share. Like, we do this for the love, but we also want to make an impact. And it's very important that we feel that we are giving you guys the information you need to be great.
Look, there you have it. All the answers in the comments, like, come on, bro. Like, relax. You're doing too much in the comments, all right? I just had to say that.
What's the answers?
He's crazy. This, all the answers is just too much.
You know what? There are people with all the answers, but none to execute.
Nah, but he's on a whole different level. He's going crazy about everything. That he needs to focus on the information and not focus on other stuff. You know what I mean? Get your mind together, bro. Like, this is why we don't get nowhere, because you focus on the wrong thing. You're thinking with the wrong head, bro. Seriously, like, get your mind right, man. Like, we out here giving gems, and it's like, all I see is his foolishness. But anyway, and FYI, we'll call anybody out.
It doesn't matter.
It don't matter if this is live or pre-recorded. I'm going to say what's on my mind. I know the producers is like, what is he doing?
She did. All right, let's wrap it up.
Look at her face. Yo, so that's it. This is Matt Garland, NMLS number 58700, better known as MG the Mortgage Guy.
And my name is Kiana Watson, license number 317576. I am a broker extraordinaire. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of the Rants and Gems Show.
Peace. Love y'all.